Many business owners are not actually complying with this, but they are not aware, but it's an offense.
Okay, understand. Because this topic is a bit technical, so I guess we can do like a screen share on the examples of withholding tax calculation. Welcome to the iSearch podcast. Today we have Richard from RW William back on the show. So today I'll be discussing with Richard on withholding tax in Malaysia. So this is specifically for business that runs Facebook ads and also Google ads. So with more Malaysian companies investing more of their marketing budget from traditional to digital, this episode will provide you with the steps your business needs to take to comply with the withholding tax in Malaysia. So welcome back to the show, Richard.
Hi.
Okay, so let's begin the topic. So could you explain a little bit on like what is withholding tax?
Generally, withholding tax started because of services to cut the tax, leakage of tax. So in Malaysia, let's say it's a worldwide thing. In Malaysia, let's say a foreign contractor or a foreign supplier come here to do services, right? Let's say the bill, the invoice for the services, technical services, they come to your factory, they do technical services, they come from Singapore. So your services cost 50,000. So end of the day, we, the Malaysian company, will pay the foreign supplier, foreign services who are not tax resident in Malaysia, the 50,000. So what but they don't pay tax in Malaysia. So what the government have done, and I said it's a worldwide thing, before we pay Malaysia and Singapore, there's a withholding tax rate. So we have to deduct the withholding tax rate. Singapore, I think, is 8%. So you deduct the withholding tax, the balance you pay to the Singapore supplier. The withholding tax portion you pay to the Malaysian inland revenue. Right? So this withholding tax, how does the Singapore company recover? When they do their tax computation in Singapore, when they have profits, let's say they have to pay the tax of 10,000 to Singapore government, but withholding tax deducted 5,000 in Malaysia. So they only pay 5,000. So that's the concept of withholding tax for services performed in Malaysia by foreign providers. Then lately, a couple of years ago, withholding tax actually there were a few categories on technical services, on interest, on royalty. Now today we are focusing on Google and Facebook. So for Google and Facebook, the inland revenue has categorized them as royalty. So you get services from Facebook and Google, is considered you getting a royalty service. When it's a royalty service, the place of the where the service is consumed or service provided doesn't matter. Just now I was saying the normal, the other technical services, the interest and all these things, the service must be provided in Malaysia by a foreign provider. But for Facebook and Google, no. These are considered royalties. That's why a lot of businesses are going through this dilemma. They have to deduct this withholding tax. Withholding tax actually depends on countries. Malaysia have treaty with various countries. So like with US, this royalty is 10%. Later we'll go through the retail mechanism. So that's how this withholding tax concept came into picture. Many business owners are not actually complying with this, but they are not aware, but it's an offense.
Okay, understand. Because this topic is a bit technical, so I guess we can do like a screen share on the examples of withholding tax calculation. So we'll jump on the screen.
So now, because our focus is on Facebook and Google, let's assume you have an invoice from Google for 2,000. It's converted to RM, not 2,000. So Google is actually registered in Singapore. So the Google services ad that we do in Malaysia, everything is registered in Singapore. So the withholding tax for this royalty on this is 10%. Again, like I said, the conventional royalty condition, you deduct from your invoices, then you pay the balance to them. But people like Google and Facebook, they will not allow you to deduct from your invoice. That's where the taxpayer, the businessman, have to bear that withholding tax. Right? So it's a 10%, so we have to gross up. So it will be 2,000 times 100 over 90. So 2,000 times 100 over 90. So we get 2,222. So this is the gross up amount. So the calculation that I said, the withholding tax is 10%. So 10% of this 222 ringgit. This is the amount the businessman, taxpayer, have to remit to Inland Revenue Board of Malaysia.
This is the amount, right?
This is what you need to remit. For Facebook, Facebook is registered in US. So with US, that also 10% is a similar concept. Again, I said, you don't expect you can deduct from the Facebook invoice. Because if you don't pay them, Facebook, the full, they won't provide the service. So who bear? The service recipient will bear this withholding tax.
Okay, so which means, correct me if I'm wrong, let's say if a business, they spend 2,000 ringgit on, say, Google or Facebook. So this one will be payment to these two fellas, like Google or Facebook. And then on top of that, they also have to pay this 2,222 to LHDN.
Yes, you are right.
Oh, okay.
So
I guess
increase the cost of business.
Okay. So which means that if they say that, okay, if I want to spend 2,000, actually they are not spending 2,000. They are spending 2,000 plus this 2,222. So in total, they will need to spend this amount of money where split payment of 2,000 to Google and 2,222 to LHDN. That's the correct way of calculation for withholding tax.
Okay,
understand.
Yes.
Alright, so this is clear now. So for Google and Facebook, it's 10%. What about the other ads? Like there's also TikTok or what else I can think of? YouTube.
On royalty, I would say it's all 10%. Generally, YouTube is from which country? Is it unless they incorporate a Malaysian entity?
Okay. Sure, so this problem. Check. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So the problem comes from
one of the.
Okay.
So the invoice is actually coming from a US entity. So if, let's say, TikTok, they incorporate a Malaysian entity, there won't be any withholding tax.
Okay, so similar. That means that if Google and Facebook, they also incorporate a company in Malaysia, then there'll be no such withholding tax. It's just because they incorporate in overseas, so now business have to pay for this withholding tax.
Yes. An extra cost to business.
Okay. This is quite a blow for many business. Okay, so next one is Facebook and Google Ads deductible for tax purposes?
So this 2,000, just how we said, so you spend 2,000 under Facebook, the 2,000 will be a tax deductible expense. You can minus from your income piece. But the 222 is not tax allowable. So something very peculiar and could be very unfair, but that is a rule. So the Inland Revenue stand is because you bear this cost of 222, which is actually not your cost directly. Google didn't bear this, Facebook didn't bear this. So this expense is not for the production of the income, it's not tax allowable, 222. So when you do your tax computation, you have to add back this as a non-allowable.
I see. Okay, so let's say we just do an example. Let's say my revenue is 10k, and then let's say cost is let's say 3k lah. So I got 7k.
Cost
so the marketing, the marketing expenses of the 2k will be here lah, which means this is the Google Ads lah. Assuming
generally 2k.
Okay, and then they also need to pay the 222 to LHDN. So this one is the tax.
They may need withholding tax.
Okay, so which means that this amount they can claim as tax, this amount they cannot claim as tax.
Cannot claim as tax. But you can expense, but when you do your computation, you have to add it back.
Okay, understand. So, okay, what if another scenario, right? Let's say another scenario that most businesses are currently doing now means that they spend this 2,000, so that's it already. So it's 5,000. So can they still claim this 2,000 tax if they didn't pay the withholding tax of 222?
If the withholding tax of 222 is not paid, then the 2,000 ringgit is not tax allowable as well.
Ah, okay, okay. So which means that it's good for business to actually pay. Sorry?
Yes.
Okay.
So this is a cash money business. Pay. You have to pay it to allow this 2,000 as a tax deductible.
Mm. Okay, okay.
Earlier you were saying this, you pay the 2,000, you pay 222. 2,000 is allowable, 222 not allowable. Assuming you don't pay that withholding tax, this 2,000 is not allowable. So when Indian Revenue do the audit, they will add back this 2,000 until the time you actually pay the 222, they allow you to claim. But by then, your tax impact will be there already.
Okay. Well, this is really a big discovery, I think, for most businesses.
Yes, actually it's a big impact. Many, many businesses are not aware. This one just divert a bit. Like Google, Facebook, all, many businesses may not spend as much. But imagine just now I was saying the services. A lot of companies will have agreement with foreign consultants. They come to Malaysia, they do service. 500,000 service, $1 million ringgit services, then the foreign consultant will insist, I'm not going to pay the withholding tax, I'm not going to bear. So when then the Malaysia company pays for it, the implication can be high. Right? You see the 1 million ringgit consultant services is 100,000. If you gross up, you bear the 100,000, plus it's not tax allowable. So many, many companies will fail to remit the withholding tax, and then the 1 million also won't be tax allowable. For Facebook and Google, okay. I'm sure there are some companies spend considerably a lot of money.
Yeah. Means they spend, but they never pay to LHDN for the withholding tax, but they still claim the amount of the marketing expenses as allowable, meaning...
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So I guess the point that you bring up, I have to like sidetrack a bit, because even though we're talking about like Google, but also you've seen cases where people engage foreign consultants. So I just re-raise this and we just show an example of the impact of engaging a foreign consultant for businesses. Okay, let's say foreign consultant is, let's say McKinsey. So I don't think McKinsey in Malaysia, they have company here, right?
They don't have in Malaysia.
They don't have. So let's say McKinsey.
Services provided in Malaysia.
Yep, they charge to a Malaysia company. They charge to a Malaysia company for consultancy fee. So let's say they charge 100K. So the withholding tax is also 10%, is it?
Let's say 10%.
Okay. So again, the same calculation.
So 10,000 will be if you deduct. If you deduct from the McKinsey invoice, you will pay to McKinsey 90,000. You will pay 10,000 to the Inland Revenue. So in this case, there's no issue.
Oh, there's no issue.
Because the 10% of 100,000 is 10K. So you pay McKinsey 90K. Then 10K you pay to the Inland Revenue Malaysia. McKinsey will claim back from your tax computation in your relevant country. But if McKinsey deal with you is, actually the law is you have to, but sometimes a lot of agreement with 10 Malaysian company. I see many Malaysian companies tend to lose out because we need this expertise services from certain countries. These certain countries will take your advantage. They say, if you want my service, you bear the withholding tax. So that this is the McKinsey case. So if not, the 10,000, you gross up, we have to bear that one. So just not the gross up, it is 100,000 times 100 divide 90. So 111,000 times 10%. So 11,000 of withholding tax, 11,100. So this is where the Malaysian company have to bear. And it's not tax allowable.
So this is the 11,000 they have to pay to LHDN. This is the amount of withholding tax. So on top of that, they still have to pay like 100K plus 11K. So which means that 100K again, McKinsey, and 11K pay to LHDN.
Yes.
Actually, do you think this tax is inclusive?
Unless McKinsey have, in the agreement, service agreement stated, we will deduct the prevailing withholding tax. Then McKinsey agree to it. That should be the proper agreement. There are many, many companies actually follow the proper agreement. But like I said, if those technical knowledge that we really need, some of the company will take advantage. They'll force us to pay. To bear the cost.
Okay, understand. So you say that by right, it's like McKinsey is supposed to only get 89K lah, and then 11K is the LHDA.
If the calculation not 89K, it will be 10% on the service cost, it'll be 10,000.
Oh, okay.
So it'll be 90,000. We pay 90 and 10,000. Now it'll be direct on the cost.
Okay. Because
so we pay them 10,000. Yeah,
because by then, this one will be like 90K times this amount, right?
When the first instance comes in, the second instance, not relevant already. So we deduct 10K from the 100K, pay to the LHDN 10K. 90K, we pay to McKinsey. So if you make McKinsey making, they lose out. No, they don't lose out. They claim back when they do your tax computation in your country. But there's many companies don't want to wait to that level. Immediately, they want 100,000.
Yep. So do you think that this tax Facebook is like and more Google to... Is Sorry?
Facebook and Google is very straightforward because they will never allow you to deduct from your invoice. So this is a straightforward. Yeah. The business has to bear.
Yeah. Okay, understand. So do you think like this tax, the purpose is like to encourage business in Malaysia to engage more like consultants in Malaysia instead of overseas?
Yes, actually one of the reasons Inland Revenue say they want to encourage to use Malaysian consultants, but the actual facts, the technology we don't have. That's what we need. Like we don't have as good as Facebook. If we have, we don't need Google. So the actual fact, we have to use these foreign so-called consultants.
Yep.
I think one of it, the earlier years, 1970s, 80s and all, we need a lot of consultants from Germany. Germany is one of the best. So that time, the withholding tax Malaysia and Germany is zero. So lately, they have increased. So sometimes it's a treaty between the government to government. So a certain country is zero, then it's a good. You can use your service because we need your service, your technical know-how.
So the next one is the timeline of when do business need to submit this withholding tax and also what forms are required for the business to submit and also pay?
For submission, for payment, is within 30 days from the date we pay to the foreign provider. So if you pay Facebook on the 1st of May, within 30 days, you must remit the 222 to LHDN Malaysia. 30 days. So 30 days, the form for royalty is under Section 109, CP37. So that's a prescribed form for royalty, CP37. It's actually available from the Inland Revenue website. You can print it out and fill in all this form. At the moment, for CP37, IRB don't accept online payment. So you need to fill it, prepare the cash or what, go to IRB counters. So that's a bit tricky. So MCO period, I don't know, IRB give a leeway. But since late last month or so, we did some payment, it must pay direct. So the form is CP37. So within 30 days. If within 30 days, I think then 30 days you don't pay, the penalty is 10%. From the withholding tax amount. So 222, 10% penalty, 22 ringgit.
The penalty is is it like every month they're going to add the amount or how?
It's one off to 10% penalty. But the key point is if you don't pay, the gross amount won't be tax allowable. Remember we are saying the 2,000? So the 2,000 won't be tax allowable in your computation. So ultimately you got no choice. You have to pay the 222 ringgit.
Yeah, can I say that if you pay the withholding tax, you're actually saving your companies a bit of money? Because if you don't pay withholding tax, the 2,000 you can't claim for tax. And the 2,000 tax amount is even higher than the 222.
Yeah, so it comes to the effect, right? Let's say it's for a Sendirian Berhad, SME Sendirian Berhad, your tax rate is 17%. So if 2,000 times 0.17, so you waste 340. You don't allow, right, for the 17%. And then if you are sole proprietor or your enterprise, your tax rate can go much higher. It becomes the individual. So you can go up to that. Sole proprietor can go up to 30%. So depends on the tax rate, you lose out on that. This one, on the tax allowable portion.
I understand. So I just want to know more on like the procedure to pay. So which means that once we submitted the CP37, fill in the form, fill in how much we need to pay to Facebook or Google. So do we need to attach any like supporting documents behind that form to say like the invoice from Google is this much? or we just submit the form?
We don't need to attach anything, but inside the form, there are information to be filling, like name of the company that you pay, Google, the resident, which country, and then how much was the invoice amount, when is the date that you pay, and then the tax reference number of Google. So all the information fill in the form.
All right.
And the additional document don't have to remit.
Okay, got it. Very clear now. Thanks, Richard, for sharing all this. So to wrap up, is there like anything else that you would like to share with the audience regarding withholding tax?
My advice would be businesses really have to be aware. From my experience on this royalty, which was quite lately, Indian Revenue enforced on that, many companies have not complied with this requirement. So this requirement, then you will be subject to audit. You all know, I think, now with IRB having the huge KPI and all, once they investigate on the withholding tax, they will go into other area of non-compliance. That's why are we inviting this problem? Because how IRB can get sources, sometimes if you make payment from bank, right? One of the sources, you make payment from bank, let's say every month you pay Facebook 10,000, 10,000, 10,000. They can get the information from the bank. They have the intelligence. The banks are also obliged to inform to Inland Revenue Board. So they see, hey, this company A, every month they're paying to this one. Then IRB, they actually can trace all the step nature of payments. This applies for businesses. On this level. On personal consumption, is nothing to do. No withholding tax. Only for businesses.
Yeah, so the Netflix, no problem.
Why you say Netflix, no problem? Because personal consumption.
Yeah.
Okay. But some ways, generally personal consumption. On another session, we also, the next step, maybe this is on the withholding tax. But there's one issue on this, actually service tax, digital service tax. Maybe the next time we can go through, their businesses also are obliged to pay digital tax. It's something different than withholding tax. So we can talk about that on the next thing.
Sure. One thing on us is the CB37, right? Because let's say if business, the previous months, they have not paid and they want to close their account, let's say December. So what can they do to like catch up on the payment?
Yes. So company with December is financial year, they have not paid the CB37. It's advisable for them to pay before the tax submission. So for Sendirian Berhad with December financial year end, the tax submission will be mid of August, 15 August online submission. So before that, they need to make this payment. Only then in the computation, it will be allowable.
All right. And do they need to engage a tax consultant? Because it's just like one form, or they can do it themselves?
Actually, generally, they don't really need. The in-house accountant should be able to do. We have clients who hire us every submission they ask to do for them. For me, I would say the process is very straightforward. So the accountant, in-house accountant, have to be aware. But some smaller sole proprietor and smaller Sendirian Berhad, they may not have a full-time in-house accountant, so they can hire people like tax agents to follow up on these processes.
I see. All right. So thanks, Richard, for coming back on the show. So check out RW William in the link below, and I'll see you in the next episode.
Okay, thank you. Stay safe.